Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. I am Nikhil Kumar. As you already aware, the Kubernetes Ingress is officially being deprecated. The future is Gateway API. But how do you install it? How do gateways, routes, and the gateway classes work? And how do you route traffic to the real applications? In today's video, we are going to learn about Gateway API, how to install it using NGINX Gateway Fabric, and how to create a routes to route a traffic to our real application.
Before we jump into the demo, let's answer the most important question. Why does even Gateway API exist? For years, Kubernetes Ingress did the job. It was simple and familiar. But as the Kubernetes environment grew, four major issues started becoming impossible to ignore. The first is single shared ingress. Ingress has just one shared resource. Every team edits the same YAML file, so there is conflicts, overwrites, and the CI failures become a daily headache. Second is no separation of responsibilities. Platform teams want to control load balancers, TLS, and the certificates. On the other hand, developers only want to write routing rules, but Ingress mixes all of these together, so everyone steps on each other's toes. Third is limited routing. We have canaries, retries, and the header-based routing, either missing, inconsistent, or completely vendor-specific. So there is very limitation in terms of routing. Fourth is vendor-specific annotation. Every controller invited its own annotation set. Your YAML only works on one Ingress controller and become useless everywhere. And that's why Gateway API was created. A modern, powerful, modular replacement that finally fixes all these limitations. Now that we understand the why, let's quickly understand how the Gateway API is structured. Because once you see the architecture, everything else will make sense, including why it's more scalable, more secure, and much easier to operate. The Gateway API is built like a clean four-layer architecture. Each layer has a very specific job. First is the Gateway class. This is the brain behind everything. It decides which implementation you want to use. Nginx, Traffic, Istrio, etc. Then we have a Gateway. This is the actual front door of your cluster. A Gateway defines a load balancer or node port, ports, protocols, listeners. In simple terms, the gateway is where traffic enters your Kubernetes cluster. Then we have a routes. This replaces old Ingress rules. You have HTTP route, gRPC route, TLS route, TCP, and the UTP route. Route tell Kubernetes if a request comes on this host or the path, forward it to this backend. At last, we have a backend reference. Backends are usually just Kubernetes service. These are the actual applications receiving traffic. Once you understand this flow, the YAML start looking extremely logical. And with that concept clear, now we are ready to actually deploy this in Kubernetes. So let's start with the first object. So this is our Kubernetes cluster. So kubectl get nodes. This is single node RKE2 cluster. So we start by installing the official Gateway API CRDs. So for that, we can run the kubectl apply command along with a GitHub file path. So this installs all the required resources like the gateway class, gateway, HTTP route, gRPC route, and the backend TLS policy. Basically, these are the building blocks of the Gateway API. We can see these all CRDs got created. Next, we will install the Gateway API controller. So in this case, I am going to install the Nginx Gateway Fabric. NGF uses a Kubernetes controller which programs Nginx and the Nginx data plane which serves traffic. The controller watches gateway and the routes and updates Nginx dynamically, so there is no reloads required. To install the Nginx gateway, we need Helm to be installed in this particular server. So I already have a Helm installed in this, so if I run the Helm version, so I can see that Helm is already installed in this particular server. So if you want to install the Helm, so I will add a link in the description so you can check it out and install the Helm before proceeding with the Nginx Gateway Fabric installation. So first, I need to use the Helm chart, but before that, I need to use some variables. Why? Because Nginx Gateway Fabric by default uses a load balancer as a type. But I don't have any load balancer in this particular demo. I am going to use a node port service type. So for that, I need to create a values.yml file. So this is the values.yml file. At first, I am specifying the name of the Nginx Gateway Fabric, that is Nginx-Gateway. Then I am specifying the service type. So here I am using the node port. So basically, we are exposing Nginx Gateway Fabric using node ports so it becomes reachable externally. You can use load balancer in the cloud environment as well, like you can use GCP or AWS, or you can deploy a Metal LB on your Kubernetes cluster and use the helm command without any values.yml. So it will by default pick the load balancer as a service type. So let me come out of it and run the helm command for this. So helm install ngf stalls the chart and OCI and the path. This is where the ngf is stored as a OCI helm chart. Then we are specifying to create a namespace and specifying the namespace name. And at last, we are specifying the values.yml file, using which the helm will install the NGINX Gateway Fabric. Now, if I hit enter, so it will start installing the NGINX Gateway Fabric. So NGINX Gateway got deployed. To verify that, we can run kubectl get all hyphen n and the namespace name, which we just created using the helm command, that is NGINX hyphen gateway. And we can see all the pods and services are running fine. And the NGINX Gateway Fabric automatically creates a gateway class. So to see that, we can run kubectl get gateway classes. There's a typo in the spelling, it's double S. And we can see the gateway class got created 76 seconds ago with a name called NGINX. This is extremely important because our gateway must use this class. So how the gateway class behave? So NGINX Gateway Fabric automatically updates the gateway status using the IP of the service it creates. So if the NGINX Gateway Fabric service is load balancer, the gateway will get the load balancer IP. But if the NGINX Gateway Fabric service is using node port, then the gateway will show the node IP or the host name. And at last, if there is no service exist, then the NGINX Gateway Fabric falls back to the pod IPs. Now we have deployed the NGINX Gateway Fabric and the gateway class also got created. Now let's deploy a two simple application. So for that, I already have a YAML file created. So this is the YAML file which first creates a service for the green application. Then we are deploying the green application using the deployment resource. Similar to that, I am also creating a service for the blue application and deploying an application with a deployment resource for the blue app. Now let's quickly deploy this application. So kubectl apply hyphen f apps.yml. So the pod and the service got created and it got created under default namespace. So kubectl get all. We can see two pods are running for each of the application. One is for the green and another is for the blue. And the service also got created. Now we have installed the controller and our applications. Next, we create an entry point for external traffic, the gateway. Think of this as a load balancer or the front door that receives the request from the cluster. So for that, I will show you a YAML file for that. So this is the one that is nginx-gateway.yml. So at first, we are specifying the API version. This tells Kubernetes we are using the gateway API v1 type. That is a standard for gateways and the routes. Then we are specifying the kind, that is gateway object, that is the actual entry point that receives the traffic. Then we are specifying the metadata. Under that, we are specifying the name and the namespace. So here I'm going with the default namespace and specifying the name, that is colors-gateway. Then I am specifying the specification. This is critical because it tells Kubernetes which controller should manage this gateway. NGINX Gateway Fabric already created a gateway class named NGINX during the installation. If this name doesn't match the controller gateway class, then the NGINX Gateway Fabric will ignore this gateway. So we will not be able to serve or assign any IP address to our gateway resource via NGINX Gateway Fabric. Then below that we have a listeners. It defines the protocols and the ports the gateway accepts. And below that, I am specifying the listener, that is HTTP. This is a logical name for the listener. It will be useful for observability tools. Below that, I am specifying the protocol, that is HTTP. That means we are accepting the plain HTTP request. For TLS, you would use TLS or configure TLS on the listener part, which we are going to do in the next demo. Below that, we are going to specify the port, that is 80. And then we have allowed routes namespace. So this restricts which namespace can attach HTTP route objects to this gateway. So here same means Only routes in the same namespace that is default are allowed. So you can set all in if you want cross namespace routes, or you can use same in case if you want to route the traffic within the same namespace. So here I'm going with the same one. So when we apply this, the NGINX Gateway Fabric will notify the gateway because of the gateway class name and the program NGINX accordingly. Then the NGINX Gateway Fabric will also populate the gateway address with the service IP or the hostname it created. So you will see address listed when you run a kubectl get gateway command. So let me create it very quickly. So kubectl apply -f nginx -gateway.yaml. So the gateway got created, and if I run kubectl get gateway, I can see the gateway got created, and here we can see the class. This is the same gateway class which has been created by the NGINX Gateway Fabric at the time of deployment. Here we can see program, and that is true. That means NGINX Gateway Fabric accepted the gateway and configured its runtime. And this is the IP address where the gateway is reachable. So this particular IP is being assigned by the NGINX Gateway Fabric service. Now that we have a front door, that is gateway, we need signposts inside the door to tell the traffic where to go. So those signposts are HTTP routes. So I will show you YAML for that as well. So let me open this colors-routes.yaml. So here as well, we are specifying the API version and the kind, that is the HTTP route. And below that, I am specifying the metadata, that is the namespace and the name of the HTTP route resource. After that, we have a specification section. So under that, we can see the parent ref. So that means it connects the route to a gateway. Here we are referencing the colors-gateway we just created. So this HTTP route is evaluated for traffic arriving at the gateway. So that's why we have mentioned this particular gateway, that the gateway should consider this route. Then we have a rules. The rule is an array of matches and action block. Each rule can have multiple matches and the backend reference. The first rule is for the green application. Here we are specifying the path prefix. So it matches URLs that begin with the prefix. And the value is /green. That means if we want to access our green application, we need to use /green path after the IP address. And below that we have a backend reference. And under that we have a service name, that is green-service. So that means it sends matching traffic to the Kubernetes service named green-service. And at last we have a port, that is 80. Similar to that, we have a second rule for the blue application. Here we also specify the type of the path and the path as well. And we also specify the backend reference as a service name for the blue application. Now let's quickly apply this. So kubectl apply -f colors route -.yaml. There's a typo and it should be apply with double P. So the route got created. If we run the kubectl get HTTP route, we can see the route got created. Now to test this application, we need to use the gateway IP address, which is being provided by the NGINX Gateway Fabric. So to get that, we can run the kubectl get gateway, and this is the IP address we can use. And if I run curl against this, so in this I will get a not found error because the gateway is working with no root route, because we have set only two routes, that is /green and /blue. Now let's test the paths. So if I run the same thing with the path, that is /green, we can see the output, which is coming from the green deployment. And if I run blue instead of green, we can see the output, which is coming from the blue deployment. Routing is working exactly as we defined inside the HTTP route. /green goes to green service and /blue goes to blue service. So our gateway route and service flow is fully working. Now the basic routing is set up and running. Let's talk about something even more important. Policies in the gateway API. Because this is where the gateway API becomes truly powerful. Gateway API has two types of policies. First is a standalone policy CRDs. These attach to the gateways, routes or the services. First we have a backend TLS policy, and second is backend traffic policy. So backend TLS policy controls TLS behavior for backend services. And the backend traffic policies controls connection settings like timeouts, retries and the load balancing algorithms. Next, we have a route level policies. These are not separate CRDs, but they behave like policies. For example, we have a traffic splitting, header manipulation, request response filters, retries traffic split. This gives you built-in canary support, so there is no annotation, no hacks, or no controllers needed. So now you might be wondering, how does all this map to your existing Ingress setup? Let me quickly show you how the Gateway API relates to the old Ingress. This isn't a full migration demo that I will be covering in the next video, but here's a quick walkthrough about the comparison. Here you can see in the Ingress, we have a routing rules, but here in the Gateway API, we have a resource called HTTPRoute. That means the HTTPRoute is the one who defines the routing. Then we have an Ingress class, and in the Gateway API, we have a Gateway class. That is an entry point for our application. Then we have a load balancer service. Here we have a gateway, that is our listener, that defines the implementation. And at last, we have a backend service. Here we have a backend reference where we are specifying the application services. This is just a high level idea. In the next video, I am going to migrate a real application to the Gateway API.
So Ingress serves the Kubernetes world extremely well. But as the workload becomes more complex, the model simply couldn't keep up. Gateway API fixes those limitations. It's modular, scalable, expressive, and honestly, the future of the Kubernetes networking. If this video helped you to understand Gateway API, make sure to hit like, share it with your friends, and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one.